Welcome to Echo Catcher Tara. Hello Libra, this is going to be a reading for Libra from December 16th to December 22nd. Please like and subscribe, that helps me out a lot. Please also remember that time is fluid, so when you come across this is probably when you're supposed to. The masculine feminine energies can be vice versa, as well as if I'm talking about a card and I'm saying it's you, if you feel like it more relates to somebody in your life or around you, then feel free to vice versa that as well. So I'm using the Mystical Cats Tarot, and the masculine feminine energies are vice versa. And if it doesn't apply to you, don't make it fit. So I'm using the Mystical Cats Tarot deck and the Wisdom Chakra Tarot deck, and then I will pull Fantasy Cats Oracle and an Angel and Ancestor Oracle card for you as well. So I shuffled the cards before I turned the camera on. So I almost need a bigger table, I feel like. Okay, here we go. So the first one, Libra, for you is the Tower Moment. The Tower Moment is a jarring situation that's going to happen in your life, and it happens for something to end and something new to come in. So when one door closes, another door opens. The difficult part is it's usually a difficult situation because change is difficult. But that's what that means. Wow. And then we have Ten of Fire. This represents, I feel like people are really stressed out, being dramatic, something's going on, and you're going to remove yourself from the situation is what I feel. This could be, yeah, I don't know if people are going to act out dramatically or what's going to happen, but you're removing yourself from the situation. So then we have Ace of Fire. Ace of Fire means you're going to cut something out for protection is what it means. So this is a safety card. So you have a Tower Moment. You're removing yourself from a situation where there's drama. And then you're cutting something out of your life for protection. So the Tower Moment is going to be pretty big for you, I feel, Libra, for some of you. Wow. And then the Eight of Sky, this situation is going to leave you feeling trapped. It's going to make you feel like you're stuck. And if you look at this card, Libra, the cat can definitely crawl out from under those branches, and he sees the birds coming and he's getting way more stressed out. So this tells me that you're going with it inside your head, Libra, and making the situation worse than what it is. I know it's a difficult situation. I know it's a hard time. But I can't stress enough. You need to calm down. You need to take a breath, plan A, plan B, and plan C, and I guarantee you one of those will work. And if you don't know what to do, don't do anything at all. Don't make any rash decisions. Just wait, and when you know what to do, it will come to you. So this is Sea Queen. This is my clarity card. This is when you figure out clarity, you're going to figure out clarity. This is that you're going to figure it out. It's all going to come to you. You look, her emotions are balanced. She's wearing her necklace. She's sitting outside. She's looking at the water. Everything is going to balance out, is what that says. Then you have the Strength, Major Arcana, Strength card to get through this. This would not come out, Libra, if it wasn't trying to tell you, you're going to make it. You're going to be fine. So I am so sorry some of you are going to have a very hard Tower Moment. Whenever you come across this, isn't just sorry. So then you have Ace of Earth, which to me is abundance. This is love being offered, coins being offered. So after the Tower Moment, you have the Strength. I feel like somebody's going to offer you love, is what I'm getting. And the Emperor. This would be awesome if the Emperor is offering you love, Libra. The Emperor's Major Arcana. He is an ambitious leader. So I don't know if he's going to come in and help you and say, all right, I got your back. He's kind of a boss. He's kind of like a father figure, granddad figure. You know, he knows how to make the money flow. He knows how to make the right decision. So this, I feel like, for a lot of you, after your tarot moment, you're going to get clarity, you're going to get strong, and love is going to be offered to you from an emperor. And look at this. Oh, my gosh. Libra, this is love. This is true love. Wow. So whatever, something needs to be cut out of your life is what I feel, Libra, right now, or love is not going to come into you. And you have to, you'll decide when the tower moment comes and you stop stressing out what that is and how you can make that apply. Look at Justice. This is your card, Libra. And she's got the light on the end of her hands. And this is Major Arcana. So this tells me that you're going to figure it out and things are going to balance out. They are. This is reasoning, equality. So things are going to turn equal again. You're going to be fine. And that's the throat chakra. So I don't know if it's going to take somebody to voice their love to you before you feel like it balances out again. This is Eight of Coins. This is reputation and grace. So I feel like you're feeling like one of your coins is taken away and your reputation has been hurt a little. And I'm telling you that you're going to be fine. Your reputation is going to be fine. It's going to balance out. Wow. Libra, look at this. This is the World. So this is wish and dream fulfillment. And she has that wedding dress right there on with the light at the top of her head. So I don't know if some of you are in a marriage and your marriage partner is going to make you feel like everything's going to be fine and he or she would remarry you again in a heartbeat. Possibly some of you maybe are going to get remarried if you're in a relationship, or this could be marriage coming to some of you. Very nice, very nice. So the next card is the Knight of Coins. Knight of Coins is honor. So you have the World card and you have honor, you have justice, you have the Emperor. I mean, this is just very, very good for how the reading started out, Libra. I'm very happy the whole reading wasn't like the first. Three of Cups, this is harmony, Libra. Harmony, you're going to have it. Very nice. I'm so happy it turned around. Nine of Swords. So there is going to be a little bit of grief, a little bit of regret and loneliness. I'm not sure if you're going to have to leave somebody behind to move into your new relationship or new situation with your partner, your husband or wife, but that's what that says. I feel like it's not relating to you or the person you're going to end up with. I feel like there's a little regret from this probably. And it wouldn't come out if it's not going to bother you. That's what that says. Ace of Coins. This is so awesome. This is a new venture. Tangible results. Very nice. So something new is coming to you, Libra. Five of Swords. This is a no-win situation and threats. So I feel like this person, somebody's going to be angry. They're going to be angry that you didn't make the decision they wanted you to make, or possibly you didn't stay with them. It could be a family member. It could be a friend. Somebody's going to be, gosh, I hate to use the word jealous, but when this comes in for you and is offered, somebody's going to not like it. And you need to pay attention to who's not going to like it, because they're not your friend if you have happiness and abundance coming to you. And they, oh, wow. So this is a hardship. Six of Swords. So this tells me that you're going to have a hard time with this person when they have a hard time with this. And this is the throat chakra, and this is the intuition. So this is supposed to happen, a hardship. So you're going to move into a better place, and somebody wants you to stay where you are. Departure and transition, you're moving to a new one, a new thing. The Lovers, wow, Libra, this is so awesome. I can't stress enough, some of you are found love, 100%, love, love, love. You have a lover coming into you. Ace of Cups, oh my gosh, it just keeps getting better. This is love offered. I mean, look at this. You have this, love, love, love. You have this, which is love. So you have four cards, Libra, offering you love. And it's probably one person, I feel, but they have a lot of love for you. A lot. I can't even, I'm just shocked. how the reading started and how it turned out. So then we have the Tower again. So I feel like there's probably going to be a Tower moment somehow, which means something changes and something new comes in. So I feel like something else is going to... There's going to be a Tower moment after this love comes in and offers you love. Ooh, the Moon. This could be a Pisces around you if you have a Pisces. Or it relates to secrets. And I feel like the White Wolf and the Black Wolf with their light above, the light above their head is yin and yang. And the Moon is Major Arcana, and it represents self-trust and prophecy. So it could mean secrets, but in this aspect, I feel like it means you have to trust yourself, Libra. You have to self-trust. You have to prophesize what you want your future to be like, and you can have it, is what I feel. So I feel like this is what this is telling me. You're going to doubt yourself. When that love comes in, you're going to have a Tower moment where you're going to doubt it, and you're going to doubt yourself. Don't do that, Libra. If you feel before this Tower moment comes, you second-guess yourself, I feel like this person being negative is what's going to bring it out in you. Look at this. So don't let this person make you stop this abundance of love coming to you, is what I'm seeing. Don't doubt yourself. Don't fall apart. Do not let that person make you fall apart. This negative person who could be jealous, I don't know. Seven of Coins. Seven of Coins represents progress. You're going to come to a crossroad, but you're going to make progress. So you're going to have a little bit of a crossroad. And then King of Cups, this is so awesome. This is influence. This is loyalty and admiration. So your king has loyalty and admiration for you, Libra. And don't doubt it. This says crossroads of progression. Don't doubt it. Do not doubt this person loves you. I feel like somebody's trying to cause problems for you. Nine of Coins. This is good, too. Nine of Coins represents security. So this tells me that your King of Cups is going to make you secure, Libra. He's going to do it. You just have to allow him to. Don't let your fears and insecurities of what other people are putting in your head stop you from allowing this King to bring you security. Please. Wow, it's crazy how other people really influence some people. So I'm going to pull the Fantasy Cat's Oracle for you, and then I'll pull Angel and Ancestors. So... very heavy reading, but everything's going to work out fine. Just hold your thoughts together. You had it over here in the first Tower moment. Hold yourself together. Be strong. Just rest. Listen to music. Watch a movie. Get your mind off what you're stressing out about. Movies are good, you know, to make your mind not think about what you're worrying about. So the first Fantasy Cat Oracle card I have for you is watching number 11. I love 11. I love all numbers. And this card doesn't come out very much. So I feel like this person that wants to come to you is watching you, Libra. That's nice. As long as it's not weird spying or anything. But I feel like he's watching you, or she. Feel free to vice versa. And this is traveling. So you have 11 and 10. So this person is watching you. And you're going to be traveling. This is so nice. I'm happy for you guys. 11 and 10. So let me read from the book, the Fantasy Cats Oracle deck. And aren't those cards just so cool? I love these two. I love all my cards, but these are just so cool. And these two don't come out very much, especially the watching. Very nice. Oh, beautiful. So it was 11 and 10. I'll read them in the order they came out. So let me see, 11, watching. It is an action card, observe. The situation is unfolding. Allow for time to let things develop. Employ feline alertness to watch and wait for the right moment. Is the ultimate goal worth your effort or focus? Is something bigger and better in store? Widen your view, open the window, and allow the unfolding to provide every option. What questions still need to be asked? What information is still required? Do some detective work on your own. Ask allies to gather information for you. This allows you to make your next move with grace and effectiveness. Do not let personal hunger, cravings, and greed move you before the moment is right. Rewards are reaped for those who with patience. Stay still and observe. Gifts are bestowed on those with perseverance. Cats are the active observers of any situation they are interested in. Become the active observer by allowing full embodiment of the moment. Emotions should slip away. Do not think or calculate. Simply observe. Put desires on the back burner to become a neutral tracker. Then big picture comes into focus and all relevant details will be revealed. So then we have traveling. Make a plan. Embrace the unknown. Chart a new course. Travel and change opens a soul. New landscapes and situations give you an opportunity to define yourself in a fresh and new way. Plot a new course before you step foot on your journey. Adventure unfolds. A cat moves with lightning fast speed or creeps along unnoticed. Move with the speed required. Feel the call of the wild, the wind on your face. Enjoy what you see along the way. The destination is not the ultimate goal. It is the journey holding the meaning and the key to your soul's evolution. It is possible to travel without leaving our own backyard. Embrace the unknown to engage in adventure. Cats can be free. Feel free to stray out of comfort zones and explore highways and byways that have long been abandoned by others. You discover treasures where others have failed to look. Leave the comfort of your home, yet remember where you have come from, and because your past will reach around to meet you in your future. Very nice. So let me pull one more card for you. I hope I haven't gone over the 30 minutes. I shuffled the deck before, but I just like to give it one more shuffle sometimes. So the angel and ancestor card for you, Libra, is Father Sky. This is awesome. So you see the eagle in the picture. Father Sky, yeah, I already know what this means. So it says in the book, to heal, if you have a situation with your father, that now is the time to move beyond that. So let's see. The message that your path is unfolding exactly as it needs to. You have a personal relationship with the Great Father. Know that He is lovingly leading you forward. Father Sky is the name of the Native Americans and many other tribes have given to God. So this card represents universal powers that are medicine in essence, the energies that people have called out to and looked up in times of need and gratitude. You are a co-creator of your life and every thought, feeling, intention, and emotion you have is creating the road ahead. This card also appears when there are opportunities to improve the father connection in your life. If your father figure is in heaven, know that his spirit is drawing close. If he is on earth, there's an opportunity to heal something, whether past or present. Wow, that's awesome. So I hope this helps you, Libra. Thank you for coming to Echo Catcher Tara. Welcome. Thank you, Crosswatchers. Thank you for coming to Echo Catcher. Thank you.